Hello students, welcome to the new session of e-learning. In my last lecture, we have studied history of novel part 1. In that, we have studied rise of novel and the factors that contributed to the rise of novel in the 18th century. In the second part, we will learn about some famous English and Indian novelists and their novels. So, I will just show you okay. Now in this part, that is second part, we will learn about some famous English novelist as well as English novelist. Now the novelist who started plenteous colorful tradition of English novel. In that, first is The Pilgrim's Progress by John Bunyan, which was written in 1678. Oronoko by Aphra Behn in 1688. Then John Bunyan's The Pilgrim's Progress is crucial in understanding the novel because he has written an allegory. Now, what is the meaning of allegory? It is a story or poem that can be interpreted to reveal a hidden meaning, typically a moral or political one. So that is the meaning of allegory. Means in allegory, the hidden meaning can be typically a moral or political one. So that story reveals the hidden meaning, which can be moral or it can be political. Then Pilgrim's Progress, written by John Bunyan, is an allegory of spiritual journey. Now here in the textbook it is not given, all this information is not given. And for your knowledge, I am giving this extra information based on those points given. So Pilgrim's Progress is an allegory of spiritual journey. That is a pilgrim who is making a way to the city of God. So it is, it has realism in it. So slowly and gradually, we are trying to learn about the history of a novel. The next novelist, Aphra Behn's Oronoko. Oronoko is an African prince who becomes a slave, and the story is about slavery, rebellion, and love. The next novelist, Daniel Defoe. He has written two novels. In that, first is Robinson Crusoe and Moll Flanders. Then we have Jonathan Swift, who has written Gulliver's Travel. Now Gulliver's Travel is a famous satire. So all these novels are famous novels. Then Robinson Crusoe and Gulliver's Travel are the earliest versions of the novel. Robinson Crusoe tells a story. Now you all know that novel is written in prose. It is in prose form. But if you go back in 18th century, before 18th century, novel was written in poetry form or verse form. So Robinson Crusoe is a story which is in prose form about a man who was traveling and he gets stranded. Stranded means abandoned, or we can say isolated, upon an island, or we can say on a beach. He is abandoned on a beach. So it narrates his life on that island and then how he is rescued, and eventually he is rescued from that island. So that is the story of that Robinson Crusoe. Robinson Crusoe gave birth to the whole bunch of novels which were written in the same fashion and genre. Yesterday, last lecture, I told you, genre means a style. So everything has a style. So this novel writing has also a style. Means it in before 18th century, it was in poetry form. But after 18th century, it was written in prose form. That is called genre or genre. Then in Gulliver's Travel, Jonathan Swift has written Gulliver's Travel. So Gulliver is a traveler and goes to many places. It is a satirical book which amuses children, and I think it is filmed also. So these novelists, Daniel Defoe and Jonathan Swift, they perfected English prose as a vehicle for the novel. Then we will see other major novelists of the 18th century. In that, one is Samuel Richardson, who wrote Pamela or Virtue Rewarded, and Clarissa. So both these novels are in epistolary novels. We call them epistolary novels. Epistolary novels means they are written in the form of letters. Then next is Henry Fielding, Lawrence Stone, Tobias Smollett are the important novelists of the 18th century. Among them, Henry Fielding's Joseph Conrad and Lawrence Stone's Tristram Shandy are well-known and popular novels. English novel got genre in 1740. Means novel got its identity. Before that, it was written in prose form. It was written in poetry form and verse form. But in 1740, English novel got a new genre, or we can say new style, when Richardson published Pamela and Clarissa in a letter form, or we can say epistolary form, or we can call them epistolary novels. Novel as a genre had developed with Samuel Richardson. So we can say that there are many predecessors. So novel has a history of 2000 years. So there are many predecessors. Predecessors means one who takes place of the other, or one who takes place of the other of novel in English. So there is no one man. There are many novelists who refined this technique of writing novel. So whatever books I am reading in front of you, written by the novelist, they are all available in our library. In your free time, you can go, when our college will start, you can go and read any of the novels which you find interesting. Then Samuel Richardson was the first who wrote on contemporary social and domestic life, depicting or portraying the actions of the common man. So last lecture we have studied that initially, before 18th century, there were only dramas and poems which had romanticism and tragedies. But the common man did not like all these things. So after 18th century, when industrial revolution took place, when printing press was invented, invention of wheels, machines were invented, so people got literature, newspapers, magazines to read. And the middle class person, or the middle class which developed in the 18th century, did not like imagination or romanticism or tragedy. So the common man always liked to read realistic things. So novel provided all these things to the common man or the middle class man, which emerged in the 18th century. So this Samuel Richardson portrayed the actions of common man, his problems, day-to-day experiences. So because of this, it gained popularity. Samuel Richardson's novels became popular. Then Pamela was the best-seller novel in English and also considered as the first true novel. Henry Fielding, Joseph Andrews, Tom Jones, and Amelia are the greatest novels. Tobias Smollett gave variety and vividness to the novel. Whereas Lawrence Stone portrays his characters with sensitivity and emotions. So in this era, novel has developed as a proper genre in English literature, which attracted the readers, especially the common man, or we can say common man, middle class man. Then next, the tradition of colorful novels was enriched by many other stalwart novelists such as Charles Dickens, Walter Scott, Nathaniel Hawthorne, Horace Walpole, Thomas Hardy, Wilkie Collins, and H.G. Wells. So this tradition of new novels, new styles of novels or colorful novels was enriched by many stalwart novelists. Stalwart novelist means were those who are faithful or loyal or devoted. So there, here is a list in front of you. So Nathaniel Hawthorne's Scarlet Letter is also very famous. By the beginning of the 19th century, as a genre had developed, novel as a genre had developed tremendously. Various subgenres such as sentimental novels, parody, picaresque novels, gothic novels, adventure novels were written to satisfy the diverse readers. Charles Dickens depicted the problems of urbanization and industrialization. Then he highlighted the problems of the downtrodden people in England. Downtrodden means the people who suffered during the 18th century, or those who suffered in the companies or factories due to urbanization or industrialization. So all the problems of that common man, or we can say the labor, those problems were depicted or highlighted by Charles Dickens in his novels. Then Walter Scott, he popularized historical novels. Then Thomas Hardy, he dealt with destiny and tragedy. The next is Wilkie Collins, was the master of sensation fiction. So by the end of the Victorian era, the novel had developed well, branching in several sub-genres. The next, the 20th century. So see how gradually we are coming. No, we studied about the genre of novel before 18th century, then 18th century, then the 19th century novelist, and now we are coming towards the 20th century. So the 20th century gave various novelists, famous novelists, the 20th century novelist came with innovative styles, new styles, techniques, and modern topics. In that, first is E.M. Forster, James Joyce, Joseph Conrad, Henry James, George Orwell, Graham Greene, D.H. Lawrence, William Golding, and Anthony Burgess. So if you look at the features of these 20th century novels, all these novelists accepted the modern topics and styles and techniques while writing novels. They widened the angles of the views. Then they also widened the circumference. Excuse me. They also widened the circumference of the genre by writing political, social, psychological, and other modern issues in their novels. These styles and subjects attracted the readers. Then we have immigrant authors also. In that, we have Salman Rushdie from India, V.S. Naipaul from Trinidad, Kazuo Ishiguro from Japan. So they came with new subjects for the readers, and because of that, the common middle class man was attracted towards this type of literature, and they started reading this literature instead of going to the theaters and watch drama or reading poems which were full of romances, tragedies, and imagination. So these people, modern middle class people, are the these people, they accepted this novel and they started reading it, and because of that it became famous. Then there is contribution of women novelists also. There are many women novelists who contributed to the novel writing, which cannot be neglected. In that, first one we have Frances Burney, wrote Novel of Manners, Evelina. It is a realistic novel. And Radcliffe wrote Gothic novels. Gothic novels means they include horror, terror, mystery, thriller, death, etc. Then Mary Shelley's Frankenstein. Frankenstein is a scientific novel. These were the landmark novels, we can say. After that, at the beginning of 19th century, Jane Austen had been ruling over the minds of the people through her novels. So if you look at the work of Jane Austen, she has written novels like Sense and Sensibility, Pride and Prejudice, and Emma. These novels depicted or portrayed domestic lives of young ladies. Then we have Bronte sisters, Emily Bronte and Charlotte Bronte, have created their own place by their incomparable books. Emily Bronte's famous novel we have, the name is The Wuthering Heights, and Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre are famous. Mary Ann Evans, her nickname is George Eliot. She was popular and her novels reflect psychological insights. Then next we have Virginia Woolf. She became the pioneer of stream of consciousness technique. So most of her novels are written in stream of consciousness technique. She was the first to develop this style. And if you look at your textbook, the lesson 1.5, which is not there this year, The New Dress, is an example of stream of consciousness technique. It means it is a method of narration that describes the happenings of the flow of thoughts in the minds of the character. So whatever the thoughts come in the mind of the character, those are narrated. That is called stream of consciousness technique. Then we have next one, that is Agatha Christie. Agatha Christie wrote many novels based on crime. In that, one is Hercule Poirot and Miss Marple are evergreen detectives. Other women novelists like Harper Lee, Margaret Atwood, Tom Morrison, Alice Walker have elevated the tradition further to prosperity. So we have studied about the English novelist. Then we move on to next. It is the Indian scenario, that is the Indian novelist. Many Indian novelists have contributed to English literature through their works or writings. Among them, Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay, who wrote Rajmohan's Wife. Now, this is the first novel in English by an Indian, published in 1864. Then next we have Mulk Raj Anand. He has also written famous novels like Coolie and Untouchable. Then we have R.K. Narayan, who was writer of An Astrologer's Day, first lesson of our textbook 1.1, An Astrologer's Day. Then Raja Rao. So all these are the three trios, we call them, who wrote on nationalistic virtues. They have written on nationalistic virtues as well as social issues related to society. So Raja Rao's famous novels, we have The Serpent and the Rope and Kantapura. So their novels bore either nationalistic virtues or social issues. So they made this genre popular and gained world recognition. After them, novelists like Anita Desai, Nayantara Sehgal, Arun Joshi, and Manohar Malgaonkar changed the current of Indian English novel through their works. They brought change through new subjects, topics, new ideas, and their works contained seeds of future development. Now you can see here the novelist Amita Ghosh, Vikram Seth, and Upamanyu Chatterjee ameliorated the Indian novel in English by adding new features. So if you can see, this Vikram Seth, his famous novel we have, that is A Suitable Boy and Golden Gate. These are the famous novels written by Vikram Seth. So they added new features to English novels. They improved or enhanced the quality of novel. They gave prominent position to the English novel. In recent years, we have witnessed good novelists who stunned, shocked literary world through their works. Their works enriched the world of literature by their dazzling performance. They are Salman Rushdie. You might have heard this name. So Salman Rushdie, who wrote like The Satanic Verses and Midnight's Children. These are the famous books written by Salman Rushdie. Then we have Arvind Adiga. Then we have Arundhati Roy, who wrote a novel like The God of Small Things, The End of Imagination. All these two novels written by Arundhati Roy. Then we have one more novelist, Kiran Desai and Kiran Nagarkar. Therefore, we can say that the tradition of Indian English novel has undergone a vital change and has a bright future. So these writers made significant contribution to the literature, that is Indian literature in English. So we'll stop here. In this lecture, we have seen about English novelist as well as Indian novelist who wrote English novels. So in the next part, we will see more about the history of novel. Thank you very much for listening.